Oriental Institute of Science and Technology, Bhopal welcomes you all. Today I am going to discuss Introduction to Computer Network. I am Shadab Pasha Khan, Assistant Professor, OIST, Bhopal. So, Introduction to Computer Networks, I will cover this topic under certain points. These are the points: why networks are important, evolution of network, define computer network, types of computer network, and at the end, conclusions and questions and answers. So, first of all, why networks are important? You know, networks means collection of various kinds of devices or heterogeneous kind of devices in which these devices are connected to each other and share the hardware, share the software, and share the data also. So, first of all, it allows multiple computers to share devices such as printers. It gives them access to a shared area for shared documents. It allows multiple computers to share softwares also. So networks are important basically for sharing purpose. That is known as resource sharing. Resource can be your software, resource can be your hardware, resource can be your data or maybe document. Okay, so this is the only reason why networks are important. Okay. Now, evolution of network. Before going to study any subject, first we need to understand what are the changes took place in the history. So, in the case of computer network, evolution of network, how this network is evolved. So, in 1969, ARPANET was developed. First network, that was the first network that came into existence. This network that became the basis for internet. What we are using today, internet, the ARPANET was the base. Okay, later on in 1980, NSFNet was developed. This was the network which was more capable than ARPANET, and it was only used for academic research purposes. In 1990, internet became popular. Internet was developed, and what basically is internet? Internet is nothing but networking of ARPANET, NSFNet, and other private networks. So, we need to define computer network. The computer network is a collection of, or you can say mass of computers connected together to allow them to talk to each other and share resources. Computers or networks can share hardware, they can share software and data. Connecting computers to build computer network or the internet is nothing but network of networks, and it has had a huge impact on our lives. Imagine how easy it would be to use our technology at college if you didn't have access to a local network or internet. Imagine how frustrating it is when we do not have a data signal for our smartphones or Wi-Fi or our laptops. Just imagine. So, we need to understand the classification of computer network. Classification of computer network are divided based on different criteria. The first criteria is based on geographical area. The second one is based on working. And the third one is based on transmission mode. The first one is based on geographical area. In this category, there are three types of computer network: local area network, metropolitan area network, and wide area network. Here I am talking about wired network, okay? And based on the networking, it is divided into two types, centralized network and decentralized network. And based on the transmission mode, it is divided into point-to-point network and broadcast network. Later on, we will discuss what are the differences between these kinds of networks. So, in local area network, metropolitan area network and wide area network. This is the diagram which is clearly shown the differences between these three. Now, there is another word, that is PAN. PAN is personal area network, which comes later. You know, PAN, it is basically a kind of wireless network. Bluetooth network is the example of personal area network. We will cover later on when we talk about the wireless network. LAN, basically LAN is comprising of, you know, a network which is inside one room, inside one building, or inside any college campus. That is known as local area network. Metropolitan area network means connectivity between the two cities is known as metropolitan area network. Okay, the third one is wide area network. Wide area network means what? Collection of various kinds of, you know, continents. When we connect one country to another country, when we connect one continent to another continent, that it is the example of wide area network. The wide area network is nothing but, you know, internet. Okay. Now, what is the difference between centralized network and decentralized network? As the name shows, centralized means there is one authority. In decentralized, there is no single authority. So centralized network is also known as the domain-based network, and decentralized network is also known as peer-to-peer network. Now, in the case of centralized network, it is relatively difficult to establish, you know, and decentralized network, it is easy to establish. As I said you, in the case of centralized network, one manager called server controls everything. It has the authority. But in decentralized network, no server, all are peer to each other. There is no boss in the case of decentralized network. In the case of centralized network, it is best suited for a small size organization. When the size of the organization is small, then it is perfectly okay. But when the size of the organization will become more number of people are there, and the size of the organization is very much large, then decentralized network works plays important role. In the case of centralized network, it offers more security because there is only one order, one you can say one authority. In the case of less security, in the case of decentralized network, okay. Then, what is the difference between the broadcast network and point-to-point network? Now, the broadcast network and point-to-point network, there are two different types of network, which is divided into transmission modes. In the broadcast network, it uses a single communication channel shared by all computers in the network. In the case of point-to-point network, it consists of many connections between individual pairs of machines. In the case of broadcast network, packets are sent by any machine and received by all machines. In case of point-to-point network, a packet may have to visit one or more intermediate machine before reaching its intended target. In broadcast network, an address is used in the message to select the target machine. But in the case of point-to-point network, routing algorithm plays an important role. In broadcast network, used in most localized networks, you know, in point-to-point network, it is used in large networks. Here, one question arises. In third point, an address is used in the message to select the target machine. Now, in the case of point-to-point network, address is of course used, but algorithm routing algorithm plays an important role in sending the packets, in sending the messages. Okay, and broadcast network normally used in localized network. Here, we are talking about the large networks. In large networks, we are using point-to-point network. So you need to understand what the point-to-point network is, means many connections are there between the individual pairs of machines. You know, in the case of internet also, internet is network of networks. Many devices are connected. It forms a web. So different devices are connected to each other with the help of various intermediate machines. Okay. So these are the examples of the point-to-point network. Okay. Thank you very much. We will cover the later discussion on the same topic. Computer network. Thank you very much. Thank you.